Good morning, students. Hope you all are fine and enjoying your e-classes. I, Harshika Kane, your English teacher, is back again with a new chapter of English grammar. So let us start our new chapter 6, the noun gender. In previous class, we have studied about nouns and kinds of nouns. We studied that a noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or thing. A noun is a naming word. Then we studied that there are three kinds of nouns: common nouns, proper nouns, and collective nouns. In this chapter, we will learn about genders. Before starting about genders, or before learning what is a gender, we will read some examples. First, Amit is an intelligent boy. Second, Anita is a pretty girl. Third, he writes a letter with the pen. Fourth, students should respect their teachers. Students, in sentence 1, Amit and boy are the names of males. In sentence 2, Anita and girl are the names of females. In sentence 3, letter and pen are the names of lifeless objects. Lifeless objects means things without life or non-living things. And in sentence 4, students and teachers are words that can be used for both males and females. So, on the basis of previous examples, we can say that every noun that we use has a gender, and gender is defined as the classification of a noun as masculine, feminine, common, or neuter. Now, we will study about kinds of gender. There are mainly four kinds of gender. First, masculine gender. Second, feminine gender. Third, neuter gender. And fourth, common gender. Let us study about all these four kinds of gender in detail. First, masculine gender. Look at the following sentences. This is Sahil. He is a boy. He loves his dog. In the above sentences, Sahil, boy, and dog are the names of males. The pronouns he and his also stand for a male, that is boy. They are said to be of the he gender or masculine gender. Here are some other examples of the masculine gender. The words boy, king, and cock are the names of males. Hence, they belong to the masculine gender. Nouns which name males belong to the masculine gender, like man, tiger, father, bull, uncle, brother, horse, headmaster, actor, etc. All these are examples of masculine gender. Hence, we can say that a noun that is the name of any male person or animal is said to be of the masculine gender. Example, boy, man, father, and horse. Second, feminine gender. Look at the following sentences. This is Shreya. She is a girl. She is my sister. She loves her mother. In the above sentences, the words Shreya, girl, sister, and mother are the names of females. The pronouns she and her also stand for a female, that is girl. They are said to be of the she gender or feminine gender. Here are some other examples of the feminine gender. The words girl, queen, and hen are the names of females. Hence, they belong to the feminine gender. Nouns which name females belong to the feminine gender, like woman, mother, actress, aunt, daughter, wife, sister, nun, lady, etc. All these are examples of feminine gender. Hence, we can say that a noun, that is the name of any female person or animal, is said to be of the feminine gender. Example, girl, woman, mother, mare, etc. Third kind of gender is neuter gender. Read these sentences about the pictures carefully. Look at that table. It is made of wood. Look at that house. It is made of bricks and stones. In these sentences, table, wood, house, bricks, and stones are not living beings. So, they are neither males nor females. They are said to be of the neuter gender. The pronoun it is used for non-living things. It is also of the neuter gender. Things like bus, chair, and pencil have no life. Hence, they are neither males nor females. Such words belong to the neuter gender. Nouns which name non-living things belong to the neuter gender. Neuter means neither this nor that. They neither belong to the masculine gender nor to the feminine gender, like table, book, blackboard, pin, football, shirt, wood, bag, water, etc. All these are examples of the neuter gender. So, we can say that a noun, that is the name of a lifeless object, is said to be of the neuter gender. Example, pencil, paper, book, blackboard, chair, etc. Last, fourth kind of gender is common gender. Read the following sentences carefully. Mr. Gupta is a teacher. Mrs. Gupta is a teacher. Ritu is my friend. Raja is my friend. In these sentences, the words teacher and friend can stand both for males and females. They are said to be of the common gender. Look at these words: children, baby, parents. Children can mean boys or girls or both. A baby can be a baby boy or a baby girl. A parent can be a mother or father. Hence, these words belong to the common gender because they can stand both for males and females. Nouns that can belong either to the masculine gender or to the feminine gender belong to the common gender, like parent, cousin, pupil, servant, friend, relative, neighbor, orphan, animal, etc. All these are examples of the common gender. Hence, we can say that a noun, that is the name of a person or animal that may be either male or female, is said to be of the common gender. Example, parent. Parent can be a father or a mother. Sibling. Sibling can be a brother or sister. After studying about all four kinds of gender in detail, now we will study some rules for formation of feminine of nouns. Rule 1. Some feminine nouns are formed by a change of word. It means, for the given masculine word, its feminine form will be a word which is different from the word given in its masculine form. Look at the following table. Masculine form and their feminine forms are given here. We will read and find out how rule number 1 is applicable here. Boy is the masculine form and its feminine form is girl. Buck, doe. Dog, bitch. Fox, vixen. Gentleman, lady. King, queen. Nephew, niece. Uncle, aunt. Bridegroom, bright. Colt, filly. Drake, duck. Gander, goose. Horse, mare. Monk, nun. Sir, madam. Widower, widow. Rule number 2. Some feminine nouns are formed by adding ess to the masculine. Means, we will add ess to the masculine form after taking away the last vowel of the masculine form or by making some other changes. Like actor, its feminine form is actress. We have removed the last vowel, that is O, from masculine word actor and added ess to it in order to form its feminine form. Conductor, conductress. Hunter, huntress. Emperor, empress. Prince, princess. Tiger, tigress. Traitor, traitress. Waiter, waitress, master, mistress, sorcerer, sorceress. In all these words, except for master, prince, and sorcerer, we have removed or taken away the last vowel of the masculine form and added ess to it to form its feminine form. But in the word prince, we have added double s because the word prince has already one e at the end. In the word master, we have changed the spelling and made its feminine form after adding ess to it. In master, we have changed a to I, and then we have added ess after removing er at the end, or we can say after removing r at the end, we have added double s only. Similarly, in the word sorcerer, we have removed the letter r and added double s only to it in order to form its feminine form. Rule number 3. Some feminine nouns are formed by replacing a word before or after the masculine. It means we will add a word before the masculine word or after the masculine word in order to form its feminine form. Look at the following table. Grandfather is the masculine word. Its feminine form is grandmother. We have replaced the word father by the word mother. Means we have added the word mother after the word grand in order to form its feminine form. Landlord, landlady. Milkman, milkwoman. Peacock, peahen. Manservant, maidservant. Here we have changed the word man to maid in order to form the feminine form. Or we can say we have added the word maid before the word servant in order to form its feminine form. Billy goat, nanny goat. Boyfriend, girlfriend. Now we will learn about some words of common gender. We will also learn about their individual masculine and feminine form also. Here some common gender words are given and their masculine and feminine forms are also given. Let us study about these words. Common gender is child. Its masculine form is boy and feminine form is girl. Common gender is fowl. Its masculine form is cock and feminine form is hen. Common gender is goat. Its masculine form is billy goat and feminine form is nanny goat. Common gender is parent. Its masculine form is father and feminine form is mother. Common gender is peafowl. Its masculine form is peacock and feminine form is peahen. Common gender is pig. Its masculine form is boar and its feminine form is sow. Common gender is sheep. Its masculine form is ram and feminine form is ewe. Common gender is sibling. Its masculine form is brother and its feminine form is sister. Common gender is spouse. Its masculine form is husband and feminine form is wife. And last, common gender is swan. Its masculine form is cob and feminine form is pen. Students, let us learn about some gender words again. Masculine word is boy. Its feminine form is girl. Masculine word is bull. Its feminine form is cow. Masculine word is drake. Its feminine word is duck. Masculine word is father. Its feminine form is mother. Masculine word is fox. Its feminine form is vixen. Masculine word is gander. Its feminine form is goose. Masculine word is grandfather. Its feminine form is grandmother. Masculine word is stallion. It also means horse. Its feminine form is mare. Masculine word is husband. Its feminine form is wife. Masculine word is Jack. Its feminine form is Jenny. Masculine word is lion. Its feminine form is lioness. Masculine word is man. Its feminine form is woman. Masculine word is peacock. Its feminine form is peahen. Masculine word is rooster. It also means cock. Its feminine form is hen. Masculine word is son. Its feminine form is daughter. Masculine word is tiger. Its feminine form is tigress. Masculine word is uncle. Its feminine form is aunt. Let us recall what we studied today. In this chapter, we learnt about genders. Gender is the classification of noun into various categories. Every noun that we use has a gender. There are four kinds of genders. They are masculine gender, feminine gender, neuter gender, and common gender. A noun, that is the name of any male person or animal, is said to be of the masculine gender. A noun, that is the name of any female person or animal, is said to be of the feminine gender. A noun, that is the name of a lifeless object, is said to be of the neuter gender. And a noun, that is the name of a person or animal that may be either male or female, is said to be of the common gender. Then we studied rules for formation of feminine of nouns. There are three ways of forming the feminine of nouns First, some feminine nouns are formed by a change of word. Second, some feminine nouns are formed by adding ess to the masculine. And third, some feminine nouns are formed by replacing a word before or after the masculine. After explaining the chapter in detail, we will solve some exercises now related to this chapter. Exercise A. Write the feminine forms of the following words. Here, 20 masculine words are given to you and you have to write the feminine forms of these masculine words. So let us start. First, nephew. Its feminine form is niece. Second, horse. Its feminine form is mare. Third, boar. Its feminine form is sow. Fourth, landlord. Its feminine form is landlady. Fifth, peacock. Its feminine form is peahen. Sixth, billy goat. Its feminine form is nanny goat. Seventh, dog. Its feminine form is bitch. Eighth, ram. Its feminine form is Eve. Ninth, uncle. Its feminine form is aunt. Tenth, bull. Its feminine form is cow. 11th, man. Its feminine form is woman. 12th, actor. Its feminine form is actress. 13th, master. Its feminine form is mistress. 14th, husband. Its feminine form is wife. 15th, waiter. Its feminine form is waitress. 16th, father. Its feminine form is mother. 17th, emperor. Its feminine form is empress. 18th, king. Its feminine form is queen. 19th, gander. Its feminine form is goose. And 20th, tiger. Its feminine form is tigress. Exercise B. Underline the common genders among the following. Here, group of words are given to you and you have to underline the common genders among these group of words. So let us start. First, boy, parent, landlord, drone, sheep. Among these group of words, parent and sheep are the words of common gender. Second, sibling, hen, uncle, Eve, bull. Among these group of words, sibling is the common gender. Third, dog, student, prince, lioness, enemy. Student and enemy are the words of common gender among these group of words. Fourth, teacher, actress, fowl, milkman, sow. Teacher and fowl are the words of common gender among these group of words. Fifth, peahen, swan, wife, companion, nun. Among these group of words, swan and companion are the words of common gender. Friend, mistress, neighbor, drake, gander. Among these group of words, friend and neighbor are the words of the common gender. 7th, ram, pig, niece, king, learner. Pig and learner are the words of common gender among these group of words. And last, 8th, human, huntress, sister, goat, emperor. Among these group of words, human and goat are the words of the common gender. Exercise C. Classify the following nouns according to their gender. Write them under the appropriate heading. Students, in this exercise, 20 words are given to you. 10 words belong to the feminine gender and 10 words belong to the masculine gender. First, I will read those 20 words and then we will divide them into their appropriate columns. If the word belongs to the feminine gender, we will write it under the column feminine, and if that word belongs to the masculine gender, we will write it under the column masculine. So the words are actor, sultana, heiress, king, bride, man, niece, prince, daughter, husband, hero, queen, rooster. Rooster means cock. Groom, wife, lad. Lad means boy. Priest, lass. Lass means girl. Directress and empress. So the words which belong to the feminine gender are sultana, heiress, bride, niece, daughter, queen, wife, lass. Lass means girl, directress and empress. The words which belong to the masculine gender are actor, king, man, prince, husband, hero, rooster. Rooster means cock, groom, lad. Lad means boy, and priest. Exercise D. Find the odd one out, a word that does not fit into a group in the following. In this exercise, few groups of words are given out of which we have to find out the word that does not fit into that group. We will start with first one. Boy, bitch, bull, boar, brother. In this group of words, bitch is the only word which is of feminine gender, whereas the words boy, bull, boar and brother are the words of the same category, that is masculine gender. So bitch is the odd word here and hence the answer is bitch. Second, man, monk, milkman, master, mare. In this group of words, except mare, which is a feminine gender word, all other words, man, monk, milkman and master, are the words of the masculine gender. So the odd word is mare. Third, girl, queen, nephew, sister, aunt. In this group of words, except nephew, which is a masculine gender word, all other words, girl, queen, sister and aunt, are the words of the feminine gender. So the word which does not belong to this group is nephew. Fourth, cob, tiger, boar, ram, sow. In this group of word, except sow, which is a feminine gender word, all other words, cob, tiger, boar and ram, are the words of the masculine gender. So the odd word is so. Last, book, shirt, car, Eve, stick. Except Eve, which is a feminine gender word, all other words, book, shirt, car, and stick, belong to the neuter gender. So the word which does not fit into this group is Eve. Exercise E. Rewrite the following sentences by changing the gender of the underlined words. In this exercise, few sentences are given in which certain words are underlined. You have to write these sentences again by changing the gender of the underlined words. Means, if that underlined word is written in masculine form, you have to write its feminine form. Or if that underlined word is written in feminine form, you have to write its masculine form. So let us start with sentence 1. My uncle has a pet dog. In this sentence, uncle and dog are the words which are underlined. So the opposite gender of the word uncle is aunt, and the opposite gender word for the word dog is bitch. Hence our answer is, my aunt has a pet bitch. Second, a king had 4 sons. In this sentence, king and sons are the words which are underlined. So the opposite gender word for the word king is queen, and opposite gender word for son is daughter. So our answer is, a queen had 4 daughters. Third, my grandfather was a rich landlord. In this sentence, the words which are underlined are grandfather and landlord. So the opposite gender word for grandfather is grandmother, and opposite gender word for landlord is landlady. So our answer is, my grandmother was a rich landlady. Fourth, a man with 2 boys was going to the market. In this sentence, the words which are underlined are man and boys. So the opposite gender word for man is woman, and for the word boy is girl. Hence our answer is, a woman with 2 girls was going to the market. Fifth, a hunter was running after a boar. The words which are underlined are hunter and boar. The opposite gender word for hunter is huntress, and for boar is so. So our answer is, a huntress was running after a so. Sixth, her brother is an extremely fine actor. The words which are underlined here in this sentence are brother and actor. So the opposite gender word for brother is sister, and for actor is actress. Hence her answer is, her sister is an extremely fine actress. Seventh, I met her brother and nephew yesterday. The opposite gender word for brother is sister, and for nephew is niece. Brother and nephew are the words which are underlined in this sentence. So our answer is, I met her sister and niece yesterday. Last exercise, playtime with nouns. Exercise F. Look at the following words and write the type of gender they belong to. In this exercise, 6 words are given and you have to tell that word belongs to which type of gender. Means you have to tell whether that word belongs to the masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender, or neuter gender. So let us start. First, peahen. It belongs to the feminine gender. Second, queen. It also belongs to the feminine gender. Third, lion. It belongs to the masculine gender. Fourth, cow. It belongs to the feminine gender. Fifth, shoes. It belongs to the neuter gender. And sixth, boy. It belongs to the masculine gender. After explaining and solving the exercises also, it's time for some homework now. Your homework is to read the chapter again, learn all the feminine forms of the masculine nouns given in this chapter, and complete all the exercises in your grammar notebooks neatly. All these exercises will also be given in your class WhatsApp groups in PDF forms so that you can copy down the work neatly in your notebooks. We will meet again soon in our next class with a new chapter. Till then, complete all your work, revise your chapter, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay at homes. Thank you.